Hi and welcome to ISBI. Today I'm gonna make a digital height gauge for my router table. I start by taking apart an old digital caliper. I have already removed a few parts. I remove everything what I don't need and make sure that the sliding part can move freely. Then I mark all the areas which I don't need and cut them off with the Dremel. If you wanna know how I made these fold down vise and the Dremel hanger arm, go to my channel and check them out. There are a bunch of other videos that you might be interested in. And if you haven't subscribed yet, do that as well. Before I screw the parts together again, I have to cut off this little hook on the electronics case. I use cut-off pieces from plywood to make this gauge. I keep most of the cut-off pieces and store it in bins. And exactly for this type of project, they came very handy. I transfer the shape of the caliper case to a matching piece and cut it out at the bandsaw. Then I glue these pieces to another piece of plywood. The caliper fits perfectly in this holder. It even don't need any glue or something. Because of the inaccurate glue up, there is an overhang around these shaped holder pieces. So I use a spacer piece to cut it to the proper size. I set the table saw blade to a 10 degree angle and cut bevels to the leg pieces and a holder piece. Next, I draw the shape of the leg and cut it out at the table saw and the bandsaw. I use the first leg to transfer the shape to the other leg piece and cut it out as well. I explain at the end of the video why I made the legs in this manner. Then I glue the legs to the holder piece. I change the blade to a flat tooth blade and cut the groove to the holder part, which matches exactly the third leg piece. Then I draw the leg shape to this piece as well and cut it out. I also cut the groove to this leg. With this groove, the part fits perfectly together and cannot move. With the grooves, the position of the third leg is defined, but they don't hold together very well. So I decide to use magnets to attach the leg in place. The last step is sanding all edges. And here are the reasons why I made the design as I did. Because of a little step between the insert plate and the insert ring of my router table, the legs has to be standing outside the insert ring. With the front legs angled, the width is decreased, so it fits into my router cabinet. Moreover, the stand is more stable. Because of the detachable third leg, I be able to lay the gauge down and use it to measure the distance between the fence and the bit. And if the fence is already set in place, I can still measure the height of the router bit with just two legs. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!